Very good morning all, myself Dr. Ansar Ahmed, and today we are going to talk about telecom traffic pattern. I mean this is quite interesting that what is the pattern and pattern of the telecom traffic and how it is decided, because telecom traffic is all the time it is unpredictable, it is not predecided, things change at many places. Like if we talk about this one, this is a traffic, this is motor traffic, vehicle traffic. You can see that at some point this road may be busy, sometimes this road may be busy, other time this road may be busy, and sometimes this may be busy, and sometimes this may be busy. So at one time, other time, there may be more traffic, less traffic, or no traffic at all on the roads. So this is very difficult to decide at which road or at which side the traffic is more or less, but because of many statistics, by applying many statistics, it is find out after lot of survey and to collect the data or statistics from that area, then this is decided. Similarly, in telecom traffic, we also have the traffic in terms of the calls. So what is that? I mean, within 24 hours, at what time we have the maximum calls or minimum call or no call? So what is traffic pattern? According to the need of subscriber, the telephone traffic varies greatly. And understanding of the nature of the telephone traffic and its distribution with respect to time. Okay. So it varies greatly. And an understanding of the nature of the telephone traffic and its distribution with respect to time is essential. So it is very important to find out what is the distribution of the traffic in a day. It helps in determining the amount of lines required to serve the subscriber need. So if we are able to find out the distribution of the traffic, then we will be able to lay down the lines or the trunks to serve the subscriber's needs. The variations are not uniform and varies season to season, month to month, day to day, and hour to hour. As I told in the previous lecture, that sometimes on the roads there may be a lot of cars or traffic, and some other time there may be no cars or some other traffic, and at sometimes it may be moderate. So it is it always varies, even in terms of season to season, month to month, day to day, and hour to hour. Like in rainy season, there may be less traffic on the road. If you talk in terms of month, then in summer or in extreme winter, there may be less traffic on the road, and in moderate season it may be more traffic. And day, like on Sunday or Saturday, it may be less or it may be more. And hour to hour, like school hours, business hours, etc., there may be more traffic. But the degree of hourly variation is greater than that of any other period. Okay. But the degree of hourly variation is greater than that of any period. So it is important to find out hourly one. So this is the variation of call from 8 a.m. to midnight. Here they mention that this is the variation of the call from 8 a.m. to midnight, starting from morning to midnight. And this is the graph between the number of originating calls, and these are the hours, starting from 8 a.m. This is 8 a.m. and this is till the midnight. So this is midnight, and okay, so this is midnight, and you can see that at 8 a.m. the traffic number of calls are 500. Then as time pass on, I mean this time, just see more than 1,000. Then as the time increase, it approaches to 10. Then this is 2,000, and then when all schools, offices, or business affairs are open, then it all of a sudden it shoot to maximum. That is here number of calls may be 2,500 or more. And after 11 a.m. when boss come in office, make the call, and then go for their next instruction. So it is starting down. So it is coming down. Then at 1 p.m. this is the lunch time, lunch hours. So lunch hour, this is the minimum calls, because all the persons are having their lunch. Then after 1 p.m. or 2 p.m. then call rate again increases, and this is the closing of the schools and colleges and offices. So once again call are maximum, because they wind up what is the next assignment of tomorrow. So they close up by many things. Then after 5 p.m. I mean this is this is 7 or after 6, all persons come back to home, and there is no need to make a lot of calls, because they feel exhausted, they feel tired and want to take rest. So just we can see the persons pak chuke hote hain, we can call it. So after that one, the call starting from that one, this is the just friendly calls, that we are meeting at that point or not, we are meeting in that party or not. Then slowly again after 10 it goes to minimum. So at midnight it is almost negligible calls. So this is the variation of call from 8 a.m. to midnight. Okay, these all statistics are collected by surveys. Okay, so as per their variation, the call, the lines or the trunks may be managed. If the behavior of the traffic shown in the previous slide is systematic for period of time or season, okay, it is saying that even this, if we get this graph and it remain fixed for all days, for all months, or for all weekends, then even this is quite good. But okay, if the behavior of the traffic shown in the previous slide is systematic for period of time or season, good judgment about the design of switching system or lines or trunks or any common shared equipments can be made. Even any decision or conclusion can be made by just observing the precision. If this is fixed, so we can manage the things. The combination of historical records, experiences, location of exchange, business areas or residential areas, vacations, government policies on holidays, etc., decide the design of telecom network. So these all factors become very important to design any network, telecom network or traffic. Like what are the number of vacations, government policies on holidays. Some governments like to have more holidays as compared to other government. Like there may be some tourist spot where all the time guys feels holidays. So there are many factors on the basis of which telecom traffic can be designed. So the terms, we have many terms which has attained meaning, and what that terms related to the telecom designing. So busy hour, this is a terms which is related to the telecom traffic. The uninterrupted that is continuous period of 60 minute interval for which the traffic volume or the number of calls attempted is greatest. So the period, uninterrupted period, for which the volume or the number of calls attempted is greatest, that is called BC over. So there is no gap, that is, it is always continuous starting from 1 to 60 minutes. 1 to 60 minutes. It is the busiest hour of the busiest day of a normal week, excluding holidays, weekends and special events. So it is the busiest hour. It is only 1 hour. It is the busiest hour of the busiest day. So it may be the one day of the week, of a normal week, that is apart from the weekend, excluding when we don't have holidays, weekend or special event. So this is the normal day in which we have the busiest 1 hour, in which call attempt is greatest. Peak busy hour, the busy hour each day, that is Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday and Friday, Saturday. So this is the busy hour each day, starting from Monday to Sunday, may varies from day to day or over a number of days. So it may vary from day to day. For Monday it may be different, for Tuesday it may be different, so on. Time consistent busy hour, the 1 hour period is starting at the same time each day for which the average traffic volume or the number of call attempt is greatest over the day under consideration. So that time period for which the number of calls, average number of calls or traffic volume is greatest is called time consistent busy hour, and this is almost fixed for every day. I mean, if Monday there is a hour from 1 to from 11 to 12, and Tuesday it will be same 12 to 1, then Wednesday, Thursday, Friday, all the days it will be same. The busy hour can also be expressed as a percentage, that is usually between 10 and 15% of the traffic occurring in 24-hour period. So this is the hour in which 10 to 15% of the traffic increase or occurs out of total traffic of the day within the 24 hours. Okay. Call completion rate. This is again very important term to use in telecom traffic. Based on the status of the call subscriber or the design of the switching system, the call attempts may be successful or not. Because based on the status of the call subscriber, right? That is, we are making a call. If I am making a call, I am calling subscriber, and to whom I am connecting the call, that is called call subscriber. So based on the state of the call subscriber, whether that is busy or free, the design of switching system, the call attempt may be successful or not. Obviously, if I am not free, then I am connected to other one. The call completion rate is defined as the ratio of the number of successful call to the number of calls attempt. Okay. So call completion rate is divided by number of successful call upon number of calls attempt. Kitni successfully hui aur kitni aapki call attempt hui, that is called call completion rate. The CCR parameter is used in dimensioning the network. So this is a parameter which decide dimensioning the network capacity, how much that network is capable, that is how many calls are out of how many calls are successful, of how many number of call attempts. The CCR of the CCR value of 0.75 is considered excellent, and 0.7 is usually expected. So this value, that is out of 100, 75%, if there is a 0.75% successful, then is satisfactory, and usually it is expected 0.70. Okay, so if there is 100 number of calls attempts and 0.7 and 75 calls are successful, then this is a good CCR. Okay. Busy hour call attempt, the number of call attempts in the busy hour is called BSC. Like in the previous, I gave the example that the hour, busiest hour from 12 to 1, if in that hour any call is attempt, then this is called the busy hour attempt. Okay. BSC is an important parameter in deciding the processing capacity of common control or SPC system on FX chain. So what is the meaning of that term? Suppose I collected all parameters, statics, and then for that 12 to 1, I know this is the busiest hour. And accordingly, I design the system that this is the busiest hour of the day, all days. And if somehow in that duration, number of calls are made, okay, your attempt. Because this hour was designed to accommodate peak hours, but apart that peak hours, if any number of calls are attempted, and that switching capacity or common control system or SPC exchange is capable to accommodate the call, then this is called the processing capacity of a SPC or common control system. Okay, so apart accommodating 12 to 1 traffic, if more traffic occurs or made attempt, and somewhere it control, that this is called the processing capacity of a common control SPC system. Okay, busy or calling rate, BSCR, it is defined as the average number of calls originated by subscriber during the busy hour. And this is the busiest hour, this is the busy hour. In that busy hour, if the average number of calls originating by a subscriber during the busy hour, it is useful in sizing the exchange to handle the peak traffic. Like BBS and this one are similar. It is 0.24 rural exchange and 3 to 4 business cities. These are the limitations of busy hour calling rate. Day-to-day hour traffic ratio. It is defined as the ratio of busy hour calling rate. Busy hour calling rate, just remember what is busy hour calling rate to the average calling rate for that day. So suppose for 12 to 1 you have the busy hour. Apart from this hour, there'll be a traffic within the 24 hours. So what is the average traffic for that day? This is called day to day over traffic ratio. This is we average out the traffic of the entire day. It shows how much of the day's total traffic is carried during the busy hour. So we can find out that is if we are having some traffic in peak hours and total then the rest of the average. So it clearly shows that how much of the day's total traffic is carried during the busy hours and for the rest for the average hours. It is normally 6 to 7 for rural areas and over 24 city exchange. Okay, so that is for rural areas, the peak hours traffic may be 6 to 7 more, and in cities it may be 20% more for the city exchange. I mean, this is the ratio between the average traffic and the peak hours traffic. Units of telephone traffic. Telephone traffic intensity is measured into two ways, Erlang and CCS, sent call seconds. So this is the unit. It is the international unit of traffic under the name of Anger Group Erlang, who led the foundation to traffic. So Erlang was the name of the founder of traffic theory or telecom traffic theory. A server is said to have one Erlang of traffic if it is occupied for the entire period of observation, or one Erlang present one circuit occupied for 1 hour. So one Erlang is known as the server busy for the 1 hour, or the traffic observed or the traffic cap for the period of observation. The maximum capacity of a single server is one alarm. Okay, the maximum capacity of a single server is one alarm. That is, server is always busy when you are making the call. It is always busy. It's always busy. That is, one hour long, in fact, is the traffic for one entire hour. And what is sent call seconds? A measure of the amount of traffic expired in 100 of. So, in place of 60 seconds, if the traffic amount expires in unit of 100 seconds, then this is called sent call seconds. Sometimes call cents and call minutes are also use a measure of the traffic intensity. So this is the relation. I mean, the question might be asked, that is, how many CCS 1 hour long have, or one how many CS or CM 1 hour long have. So this is the conversion. This is 1 hour long is equal to 36 CCS, that is 3600 CS and 60 cm. So this is the relation between 1 hour long and CCS, CCM, M, etc. So guys, it was all about the unit. Grade of service and blocking probability. This is very important parameters. Already we have discussed about the grade of service and blocking probability in three stage network. Though we would like to repeat here, what is grade of service and blocking probability, because these parameters actually tell us the quality or the grade of the exchange. In loss system, what is loss system, we'll discuss. The traffic carried by the network is generally loss system, actually, in which the number of if any subscribers in calling is trying to make a call and system is full, then call is get lost. What happens and how they are accommodated, that is loss system. We'll discuss in detail what is loss system. Loss system, the traffic carried by the network is generally lower than the actual traffic offered to the network by the subscriber. Because of some reasons, the traffic carried by the network is lower as it is actually offered or designed. The overload traffic is rejected and hence is not carried by the network. Okay, that is loss system. The amount of traffic rejected by the network is an index of quality of the service offered by the network and called grade of service, GOS. So what is a GOS? The amount of traffic rejected by the network is an index of the quality of the service offered by the network and called GOS. So if any subscriber is trying to get connected to system and it is denied, then of course it shows the quality of that exchange. Grade of service is defined as the ratio of the lost traffic to offered traffic. So this is grade of service is given by A minus A naught upon A minus A naught upon, that is A upon A. So this is the formula to calculate GOS, where A not carried traffic. Okay, kitna carried traffic hai, total traffic kitna hai, and lost traffic kitna. That is, if we subtract A minus A naught, then we get the lost traffic. Okay, the smaller the value of GOS, the better is the service. Okay, so this value should be smaller. The recommended GOS India is 0.002. That is, out of 1000 call, 2 call may be dropped. GOS is applied to a terminal to terminal connection. Okay, this is not all the time that is particular exchange has this grade of service. The grade of service can be terminal to terminal, from one place to other place or next place. So it varies, and sometimes it is high, sometimes it is low, because of this reason. But usually a switching center is broken to following components: an internal call, subscriber to switching office. This is also a matter of GOS. An outgoing call to the trunk network, switching office to trunk, this is also grid of service. The trunk network, that is trunk to trunk, this is also the grid of service. A terminating call, that is when it is going to disconnect the call. Then these all parts are responsible for GOS. Blocking probability. It is defined as the probability that all the servers in the system are busy. Blocking probability actually that is the all lines or trunks or the servers are busy, and if any subscriber is trying to get connected, it is rejected or denied. There is no further traffic can be carried by the network and the arriving subscriber traffic is blocked. Okay, the difference between the GOS and blocking probability is that GOS is measured from the subscriber point and blocking probability is measured from the network or switching point of. So if I'm a subscriber of any exchange, then this is my right to have the access of the call. So I will give the grade to the exchange if I'm getting good quality of service. Okay, while blocking probability is the measure from the network or switching part of V. So if any switching system or network or telecom system is not able to handle subscriber fairly, or the subscriber facing blocking the call or rejecting the call, then of course it is seen from the side of switching network. Okay, so grade of service, that is how subscriber grade to the exchange, that how much they are capable or they are happy with the exchange and switching from this from the network or switching point of view, that is how it is working or functioning. GOS is arrived at by observing the number of rejected subscriber call, whereas the blocking probability is arrived at by observing the busy hours in the. Okay, so because GOS is directly connected to the subscriber, that is subscribers, then it is observed by the number of rejected calls, whereas the blocking probability is connected to the switching system. So it is observed with the help of busy servers in the system. Okay, so these both parameters important. That is, if I'm getting good quality of service from the exchange, then of course I will grade the exchange that is really good, and it is expected that out of 1,000 calls, 2 may be dropped. But if engineer from the telecom side experience that many number of calls are blocking from their side, that they should attempt how they can accommodate more number of users. So guys, it was blocking probability. So subscriber viewpoint, that is grade of service, call congestion ho sakta hai, then loss probability ho sakti hai. Network point in blocking probability, time congestion. Okay, that is because this is related to the server. So server at one time may be busy and other time may be not busy. I mean all the time server may not busy, or we can say that at particular time or peak hours or as per the time of the season or festival it may be busy, but other time it may be free. So this is quite important parameter. So guys, it was all about the blocking probability. Okay, I hope you understand it. These are very important parameters. Please don't forget these parameters, because these are very important to design the traffic, telecom traffic. I mean, these are the terms which belong to design the telecom traffic. Okay guys, in this lecture we are going to end up. Rest, please take care and have a great time.